Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein, and in this week's episode, I'm going to show you how I manage my projects using Evernote and Todoist. Now, this is a question that I get asked a lot because I don't use projects in my task manager, which is how I see Todoist. Todoist is a task manager, not a project manager. And so, taking a leaf out of the Getting Things Done book by David Allen, I manage my projects in my project support materials, which are outside of my task manager. But when you're managing, when you're developing your projects, of course, though, there are going to be a lot of tasks that need to come through. And so this week, I want to show you how I'm going to do that with a project that I'm currently working on. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo accounts now, and I'm going to show you how I manage a real project using Todoist and Evernote. Okay, so here we are in my Todoist demo account, and I have this now nicely set up exactly how my real account is set up, where I've got my two filters, my objectives for the day. These are my two objectives for today. And then my focus tasks. And these are where I will spend the rest of the day, at least until round about, say, 4 or 5 o'clock, when I will switch over to my today view. So essentially, if you look at the way that this is all organized, I have my 6 focus tasks for today right up here. Today's Friday, so I do try to keep things limited. And then I just got my admin to do after 4 o'clock. Although this one here, record YouTube videos, that should actually have a flag. I do apologize. That's actually, I'm doing that right now. So that's a morning task. So there you go. That's basically how this is set up. But the purpose of this video is to show you how I take project tasks and move them into a Todoist. Now, for those of you who don't know, I follow a system called the time sector system. So as you can see here, there is no projects, even so within this week. These are the tasks that I have remaining for this week. And here are my recurring areas of focus that just come up when they need to come up. So how do I manage my projects? Well, first of all, I manage my projects in my notes app, which is Evernote. And here is a genuine project that my wife and I are currently working on. We have a plan to move out of Seoul and to move to the East Coast by the end of next year, actually by September next year. So what we're going to do is, because I've lived all my time in Korea in Seoul, my wife has lived all her life in Seoul, so we're going to do a test from the 30th of December to the 28th of February. So essentially, we're doing a 2-month trial. So we've organized a house to rent, and here's the house that we're actually going to be renting for the next, well, we say 2 months. So it's a really quiet place. It's only about 5 minutes away from the beach. And although in the middle of winter, this isn't the best place to go. So as I develop my project, first of all, up here, I've got my requirements. This is actually for the house that we're going to buy. But here is for the January, February house rental, which is what I'm talking about here. So these are the things to do. So we need to buy a collapsible table and office chair. If you look at the place that's going to be used for the office, which is the second floor, there isn't very much there. There's just a closet or wardrobe, as we say in the UK. But I need a quiet place to be able to get on and do my writing and do my video editing, etc. So we need to buy a collapsible table. I don't want to buy an expensive table. And we're going to have to make sure that my dog, who's on medication, because he's a very old dog now, so we need to get 20 days worth of medicine for our dog, which we need to pick up on the 29th of December, and find out the cost of a sofa bed. Again, this is what I call my studio. This is what will be the studio. And just want to know if those, you know, have a sofa bed in case we have any friends or family come over during that 2 months. At least they have a place to stay. So that's the actual things to do. And then I've got a packing list, which I'm now starting to build out because I've only got about 2 weeks before we actually move. So I need to start remembering the things that I will need to take, because this is about maybe 150 miles away from where we live. So it's not exactly just a trip back round the corner to pick up stuff. It's a good two and a half hour drive to get back to Seoul. So I want to make sure that I don't have to return within the first 4 or 5 days. But the key here, the packing list is not going to move to Todoist. That would just be silly. I don't need to do that. You know, as I put in my tasks, I can just click these off. And that, as I do my packing list, I can just make sure these are in the boxes, are in the car. So that's actually very easy. That does not need to go into Todoist. That would just be duplication. But these ones here do need to go into Todoist simply because these could happen. These need to be done over a period of time and before we actually set off on the 30th of December. So what I'm going to do is, what I would do is, I'm going to pick out these tasks. I'm just going to copy them from there, as you can see. Then I go over to Todoist and I go to my inbox. Everything for me starts in my inbox. If I click Add Task and then Command copy, it's going to Command V on a Mac. It's going to ask me if I want to add 3 tasks. So I'm going to add 3 tasks. So they are now in my inbox. Now, one of the best things about Todoist is that date recognition. As you see, I actually put here on the 29th of December. So as that's come into Todoist, that's added the date. It's added the date, the 29th of December. That is fantastic. Now, so what I'm going to do is, when is this going to happen? Well, the 29th of December is going to happen this month. So it just gets dragged into there. Because when I do my weekly planning session, I am going to see that. So really all I have to do, and as you saw from my video last week, if you watched it, let me just zoom in there for you so you can make sure. So what I'm going to be doing is, I need to buy a collapsible table and office chair for the office. So when am I going to do that? Well, I'm probably going to do that next week, because although Christmas is not a big thing in Korea, we only had one public holiday and everything then returns back to normal. I need to find out the cost of a sofa bed. Well, I may as well do that this weekend. I'm going to do that next week. And there you go, it's done. So these are now, these tasks that are in my project support material, that's over here. So what am I going to do with those? What I usually do is I just strike through. So I'm just going to put a strike through. That means, that tells me that these are now in Todoist. A lot of the time when you're doing this, and if you are following the time sector system and you don't want to get confused, that, as you saw just then, that took me about, 1.5 seconds to put a strike through. That now tells me that those tasks are in Todoist. For things like this, these don't go to Todoist because it's a packing list. That's just going to be, I just cross them off once they're in the car and ready to go. It's really simple. And as I've set this up in my Evernote, I can use my phone on the day because my computer will be packed up. So that will be all set up and done. So once everything's in here, now I've got it all organized, because I'm going to be looking at this week. Is there anything I need to be doing here? No, all of it's going to be basically next week. So when I go in to do my weekly planning session on Saturday, then I know I've got all these down here and I will see them and I can decide, oh yeah, this needs to come into next week, and I can actually just add a date to them and move them into my this week folder. And that's it. That's really how I manage my projects. It's really, really simple, because as I say, all this stuff that I've got in here, I cannot really put into Todoist. And so when I'm planning out, when I'm thinking about a project, when I'm thinking about what needs to happen next, you know, I find it so much easier to have this freedom and space to be able to throw in all sorts of ideas before making sure that I can move stuff over, before I make turn them into tasks, because it gives me much more clarity about what needs to happen next. So hopefully that's given you a good idea, because I do get a lot of questions on this about how do you manage your, you know, do your tasks, when do you send your tasks over to Todoist. Well, this is exactly how I do it. Although this is my demo account, this is really exactly how I do it. This is exactly what I did with this house move project. And in my master project list, which is here, this has now moved up. And because we've now paid 2 months rental, it's all paid and it's been agreed. So really, that's now moving this project forward. This hasn't changed, because the actual ultimate project, if I go to the house move project, the ultimate project is still to move house, not just to rent a place for 2 months. This is a long-term project. But what we want to do is to see, is this going to work so we can do a two-month trial, particularly as we're still in COVID and we're likely to be in for the first quarter of next year. I may as well take this opportunity and do this test to see if it's going to work. So there you go. That's how it all works. Hopefully that's given you a good idea of how I'm managing my projects in Todoist. And hopefully that will give you some ideas, particularly those of you who are using the time sector system, how you can use the actual tasks within Evernote. One more thing before I do that, and I'll just do this in my inbox. I can actually do something like this. Review. Oops, we're going to go review house move project. And you can do this with OneNote, by the way. It's a little bit more complex with Apple Notes, but certainly with Evernote you can do this. What I can do is I can go in here, more actions. I can say copy internal link. I usually copy the app link. Now this isn't going to work at the moment simply because I'm using the web, but what I can do is I can actually paste that in here. So paste the note in there, and then I can just put that in brackets. So let's just put this in brackets. And I've created a clickable link. And basically what I'm doing is I'm removing the barriers from actually being distracted about what I'm doing. So this could come up, review house move project. And again, I can just decide, okay, I'm going to do that next week. So I'm just going to drag that in there and it's done. That's it. That's all I have to do. So when I do my weekly planning session, I've got this here and say, oh yeah, I need to do that on Friday. I can just click on here. I can just tip on Friday and the date, and it's going to be a priority. So I can go in there, I can make that a priority, and I've already done it. That's essentially how I would do my weekly planning session. And of course, this task would then be moved into this week. Of course, I'm not going to do that just yet, but that's basically how everything works. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this video, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.